I'm Rebecca Lindquist with English by the Hour, and what I'd like to talk to you about is energy typing. Now, what's so interesting about this is I have been an accent reduction coach for years, and only in the last 3 or 4 years have I begun to explore other modalities. Now, what I've found is that many of my clients, while they hire me to work on their accent, find that as their accent changes, their speech also changes. And many times their nonverbal communication does not sync with their verbal communication. Now, I am not a presentation coach. There's plenty of folks out there to help you with things like keynote speaking and presentation skills. And certainly there are speech clubs you can join to practice. However, many of these organizations and individuals who coach you are set up to assume you speak English and to help you with other things. Whereas my focus is working with non-native speakers, those who speak other languages as their first language, and perhaps more importantly, come from different cultures as their first culture. So something I discovered recently, just a few months ago, is the concept of energy typing. Now, I don't know how many of you are aware of this. Many of us think about personality typing. Have you heard of the Enneagram or the Myers-Briggs or the DISC? These are tools they use often in leadership coaching to help clients to work specifically with how to look at personality and how it affects their speech and how it affects other elements as well. The thing about personality that Carol Tuttle talks about, so this energy profiling that I'm mentioning, I'm referencing Carol Tuttle, who wrote a couple of books. She wrote one called It's Just My Nature. This is the Kindle version that I have on my iPad. She also wrote a book called Discover Your Type of Beauty. And she has an organization online called Dressing Your Truth. And some of you may have seen this before or be familiar with it. If you're not, I strongly recommend that you check it out. It includes things like this that talk about the colors. This is for a couple different types. I won't tell you what my type is yet. But Carol identifies 4 types. And what she said in her books and on her materials online about energy typing is that it may be more reliable as a source of understanding how people are and how we best express ourselves in many, many ways, from how we talk to how we appear, how we show up, how we interact, how we look and how we dress and everything else, it may be a more reliable tool than personality. Because let's face it, our personalities are formed in reaction to others. So regardless of what tool you use to identify personality, it could have something to do with our childhood and how we reacted. It could have to do with the situation. It could have to do with birth order. It could have to do with so many different elements in our environment and how we adapt to them. So we don't have a stagnant personality that doesn't shift that came with us from birth. In fact, just the opposite. Our personality has shifted and changed. But what Carol talks about is energy typing, and she identifies 4 types. And I'd like to talk about those types in conjunction with something different that she hasn't yet, to my knowledge, talked about. And that is, how does energy typing relate to how we speak? The styles that we use and the energy, in a sense, that we bring to our speech. It's so important because I realize something about myself, and that is I bring my own energy type to my speech. And not only that, there's really nothing wrong with that. I'm aware of it now, but more importantly, as a coach, I need to make sure that I'm coaching my clients to embrace their own energy types and not to take mine on as the standard or as an American standard. Now, the same is true in accent reduction. That's the reason it's important not to say repeat after me, because a lot of an accent is keeping who you are, not changing your identity, but learning to speak clearly and effectively. It's not about copying or mimicking someone else. The same is true, I would argue, of energy type. And so there are 4 types I'd like to share with you today. Now, type 1, she identifies as a buoyant or a light type. So one more thing before I share this buoyant or light type with you, and that is traditionally in teaching, we have thrown out there the concept that some people are visual, some people are kinesthetic or tactile, touch, and some people are primarily auditory or hearing. And so therefore, as teachers, we should use all 3 modalities. That's sort of standard wisdom, right? That when I'm presenting, I should do something visual, I should do something auditory, that's maybe why I should have a handout, in addition to talking, in addition to changing the tone in my speech to keep you interested, maybe kinesthetically I should ask you to raise your hand, stand up, move. That's why in the accent world I use a rubber band technique, I use breath techniques with tissue because I want you to feel it as well as see it and hear it. Now that's different than energy typing because the idea is not to take on someone else's energy. So while the idea in teaching is to apply what is learned visually, kinesthetically, and auditorily, of course, and perhaps written word as well, some would argue, when I'm conveying something with my own energy, doesn't it make sense, just like personality, that I use my energy, not someone else's, not some other style that I think will make me seem more effective, seem more personable, seem more successful, or achieve the results I desire? Perhaps if I stay true to myself and to who I am and what I want to present, I'll do a better job than if I try to impress you. So let's talk about how that plays into the four energy types. So number one, as I mentioned, is a buoyant light type. So if you think about buoyant and light, I'm going to demonstrate number one, and then I'm going to ask you at the end of this video to identify what you think my type is. So I'm going to pretend to be all four types. Now I actually do have a primary and a secondary, but I'm not going to tell you what it is. So number one is a very light type. Number one is for people who have energy that's kind of changing and moving. It's the highest movement type. So let me show you a little bit of that animated feel that might come along with being a type one. So this is type one energy. Now any one of us can exude this type of energy, whether or not it's our primary energy profile type. So that is, if you went through her program, which you can do, read her books and go online, and identify, hey, I think I'm a one. If that's the case, you may actually end up dressing differently. Now I tell you, when I heard dress had to change, I threw up the wall. And I said, you know, I already know how to dress. That's actually true to my energy profile. You'll find out when I talk about the four profiles. Is there some of us who say, wait a minute, I'm not a kid anymore. I know how to dress. Don't try to tell me how to dress. But the thing is, this isn't the old style of dressing. That, you know, many of us have been given the same advice. It's kind of that standard tried and true advice. When you go to an interview, you wear a suit. Have you been told that before? Standard issue, right? And for women, a pearl necklace. Why? Because we don't want to wear anything that somebody might take offense to. We want to appear to be generic, and then we can sell based on our knowledge base and based on our personality. But the challenge is, I think the huge challenge that Carol Tuttle talks about in her books, is that if we're not tapping into our native energy, then we're doing ourselves a disservice and we won't come off as authentic and genuine. So if we dress our type, and a type one is going to be light colors, bright colors, lots of movement in everything from hair to dress to jewelry to, for men, to the style of clothing, whether you wear a tie or not, what style tie you wear, what shirt, what pants, what style you bring to the game. So this can actually put you either in touch with your energy style or not. So let me continue with type one. I'll give you a little more type one. So type one is, it has lots of different ideas and they go here and there and it's very animated. It's very light and buoyant. It's fun. And the type one word is fun. Everything's fun. There's a little bit of laughter, a little bit of a smile to it. And this is type one energy. Now let's segue into type two energy. Type two energy is a little softer. It's a little more muffled. And muffled in a good sense, not muffled in a can't hear you mumbling sense, but a little bit softer, a little bit perhaps more deliberate, but certainly more fluid and flowing. So now I'm talking in a type two style. The voice gets a little softer. It may not carry as well, but it has a soft, comforting effect to it. And we could analyze it further. What qualities are in it, right? What's happening with the vocal folds? What's happening with the breath? Certainly. But for the purposes of this video, let's look at how fluid and how the movement is super fluid. Style number three, a little more choppy, a little more deliberate, a little more reactive, active. Style three is geometric shapes. Now, one thing Carol Tuttle talked about that I thought was fascinating is how we doodle, you know, how we draw. Type ones draw with little stars and hearts and shapes, and type twos draw ovals and S-shaped curves and have sort of an S-shaped movement. And it's a preferred movement. It's also a face movement. Type threes tend to move in more rough and rugged ways. And if you like the concept of yin and yang, one and two are more yin, three and four are more yang. And we can have a combination, of course. But the idea here is to try to find which type you most resonate towards so you can make a consistent decision about how to appear, how to dress, how you are 80 to 90% of the time, and then you can dabble in these other styles. So a type 3 style is more deliberate, a little more punchy, a little more sharp, perhaps more rough textures in clothing, and a little more abrupt, and a little stronger. So each one of these styles can get feedback from people. You can think what the feedback might be. A number one, who's kind of like this, might be seen as ditzy on their negative side, right? Very creative on the positive side, but perhaps a bit ditzy or goofy, right, in some ways. A type two could be seen as being too soft, too docile, not strong enough, thinking too much, asking too many questions, taking too much time. A type three could be seen as too punchy and too reactive and too jump in and get it done and not caring enough about others. Because obviously these judgments come from someone who has a different personality type, or in this case, energy profile type, than we do. And the fourth type is stillness. Now, stillness doesn't mean no movement at all, but it might mean deliberate movement, it might mean holding a movement, and it might be not making much movement at all. Now, what Carol Tuttle talks about in her book, which I find fascinating, is that the fashion world has embraced type 4. So when you think of a model, you think of the straight long hair, the sharp hues of colors. Hues meaning saturated color, that is pure colors not mixed with something like gray, white, or black. A type 1 is mixed with white, much lighter colors, more movement and pattern, and certain types of patterns. Type 2 has some gray added, so it's a softer tone to go with the softer personality. And type 3 is a shade, so you've got some black in there with those colors. So this comes from the color spectrum world. I Googled it and found that fascinating. Type 4 is more of a pure, solid color, very little movement. So when you think in terms of a beauty magazine, you expect sort of this cold, distant look, slow movement, flat, sharp lines, long hair, and black, wearing black, right? The little black dress. Whereas what Carol often calls the little black dress for a type 2, for example, is actually a gray dress with some silver jewelry and some softer shapes. So again, coming back to how this affects speech, if you dress your type, feel your type, and are your type, you will come across as more authentic to others by acting your type. So my question to you, after watching me do this entire video, what type am I? I have a primary and a secondary. I've begun, after reading and materializing, making this active in my life, bringing it material or bringing it real for myself, I've begun to use my energy type more consistently, and to put a focus on not only pulling from my primary, but also my secondary. So in terms of clothing, I do some of one type and some of another, and I mix the two now because I feel more comfortable and more confident and more in my own skin. I would invite all of you to record yourselves, to videotape, and see how you come across. So what are a couple of energy types of questions you can ask yourself? First, ask yourself, how do I feel comfortable? Do I feel comfortable with light, buoyant energy? Do I feel comfortable with smooth, flowing energy? Do I feel more comfortable with choppy, fast, reactive types of energy? Do I feel more comfortable with still energy, where I hold things and take my time? Now, how do other people perceive me? Because if I think I have to be a type 3 to get results, but really I'm a type 4, how good are my results? Perhaps people are reacting to me that I'm too aggressive. It might be in reaction to a real 3, could be learning to embrace your own style, but it could also be that I'm a 4 or a 2 or a 1 trying to be a 3 to get results. And that, of course, is just like personality profiling. Trying to be someone else is never going to help you, never going to serve you. So the idea is to tap into your real energy by asking that question, how do I project my best? How do I show up? Which is one of those popular buzzwords in leadership coaching these days. How do I show up to others? How does my style show up? Do people feel that I'm being authentic? And if you're getting feedback that they don't, it may be that you're tapping into the wrong kind of energy. So let me give an example from my world. And that is, I've often coached people to certain types of energy that I thought were very American. And now I realize that all 4 types can play out. that there isn't one particular type that's best or preferred, but that it is important to be genuine and true to yourself and to be consistent. You may dabble with different types and play around, but when it comes time to deliver that killer presentation that you really want to work and to communicate your ideas in an effective way, you need to be centered around who you are. So I would invite all of you to give me some feedback. What type am I, primary, and what's my secondary? Remember, type one is the light, buoyant type, the fun, crazy, animated type. Type two is the fluid movement type and the flowing, softer voice type. Type three is the more deliberate, reactive, choppier, faster movement, more aggressive, more assertive, more get it done, a sharp curves, yang energy type. And type four is also more of a yang energy type, but it's a stiller, focused, slower moving, comfort in stillness, moving a little bit slower and less reactively. There's no right or wrong here. There is in terms of my style, for me personally, but there's no right or wrong in terms of which type is best. But it's important to dress your type, feel your type, exude your type, and really own and be your type. I hope this has been as helpful and insightful for you as it was for me, and I invite you to visit Carol Tuttle's website, Dress Your Truth. I don't work with her. I'm not affiliated with her in any way, but I found her work to be so informational and so insightful and helpful to me in developing yet another aspect of speech coaching. Thanks for your time, and have fun trying out your new energy type. Please get back to me and let me know which type you think I'm expressing here in this video. Guess my primary and guess my secondary if you can. Thanks for your time.